Hello everyone, today we are going to learn the 16th chapter from your English literature, which is Dada the Good. This is a story about a shepherd who was very kind and a very good advisor. So let's go through the story. Long time ago, there lived in Iran, in a small hut on a hillside, a shepherd named Dada. He never learned to read or write like other shepherds in those days. But he was a very good and kind man, and with age and experience had gathered a great deal of practical wisdom. He often helped the nearby villagers in their troubles with sympathy and sound advice. This way, his reputation was as a friend of the poor spread far and wide, and he came to be known as Dada the Good. But Dada did not forget even for a moment that he was still a humble shepherd. Whether he was watching over the flocks of sheep on a hillside pasture or trying to solve the problems of the villagers, he always wore an old sheepskin cloak over his ordinary clothes. This was a constant reminder to him of his poverty and humility of his occupation. By and by, the news of the Dada's success as a popular advisor reached the ears of the king. The king had fallen upon evil days. On the account of his disloyalty of some of his ministers, there was a discontent and even revolt in the country. It means some of his ministers were not loyal, and because of that there was a kind of disturbance in the country. He needed the advice and good men who could save the king from this distress. He therefore called Dada to his palace. The king was struck by the sincerity and common sense of the simple shepherd and decided to make him the governor of a small province. It was with a great deal of hesitation and reluctance that Dada accepted the king's offer. But though he was not quite happy in this new post, the people of the province were overjoyed to see that their friend and advisor had become their governor. Now, instead of moving on foot, Dada now rode a horse. But apart from this, there was hardly any change in his formal mode of life. He still lived in a small hut on the hillside. His meals were as simple as before. He wore the governor's cloak over his ordinary clothes, which he refused to discard in spite of his high position. So Dada was made the governor of a province, but he did not want to give up the previous lifestyle of a shepherd. He did not want to give up with his old clothes. He did not want to give up with his old clothes because all this reminded him of his being humble shepherd. As he went from village to village, he listened sympathetically to the complaints of the people and took steps to see that these complaints were promptly attended to. The people had now enough to eat and lived contentedly. So he made the round of the villagers. He listened to the people's complaints very carefully and also took the necessary steps to solve the problems immediately. And because of this, the people now lived a happy life. As Dada went on his official round, a mule carrying an iron chest always followed him. No one ever saw what was in the chest, but everybody noticed that the governor took special care of it. As days passed, some foolish person started the rumor that the chest contained gold and silver. So as Dada went on his official rounds, he always would have a mule behind him carrying an iron chest. No one have ever saw what was in the box, but they always noticed that the governor took special care of the box. So some foolish people started to pass the rumor that the chest contained gold and silver. The rumor spread rapidly and many villagers began to believe that Dada was making himself rich at the expense of the poor. The governor soon lost the trust and confidence of the people. When the king heard about this, he was deeply distressed. But instead of relying on the reports of his ministers, he resolved to find out the truth himself. He set out one day to visit the governor of the place where he was camping. As the king approached the camp, Dara went forward to receive him on horseback. A servant followed him, leading a mule with an iron chest on his back. Now the king, seeing the iron chest, was beside him with anger, refused to acknowledge Dara's greetings. The king shouted, "I made you the governor, but you have proven yourself unworthy of the post. You have robbed the poor of their money. Open the chest and take out all your evil gotten treasures." Dara quietly opened the chest. What was the king's surprise when he saw the shepherds bringing out from the chest not gold and silver, but an old worn out sheepskin cloak. "My lord," said Dara, "this cloak is my only treasure. I carry it with me wherever I go so that I might not forget that I am still a humble shepherd." So children, the king felt ashamed, yet how happy he was that his suspicions were baseless. Turning towards his ministers, he said, "Dara, whom we unjustly suspected of being dishonest, is the humblest and the most faithful man that can be found in the country. And I reward him by making him the governor of a large province now." With this, we end the story here. So, what is the moral of the story, students? Honesty is always rewarded. That's all in this session today. In my next session, I will come up with yet another new topic. Till then, take care and goodbye.